stop looking at everyone else to be in your lane. Like, build your own lane, do your own thing, and worry about nobody else. Boom, boom, boom.
It's your girl Sadia Dior, Instagram at starring Miss Dior, and you are now rocking with the Bombshell.
My name is Claudia. I'm a music exec in training, and I'm also a Bombshell. You dig?
So I am a woman of many hats, and the way that I found balance is to be spiritual and to go to my therapist so I can kill nobody in the future.
Work ethic to me is really important because I feel like my work ethic is also my reputation. So the harder I work, the better reputation I have in the business.
Hey, I'm Shanae Perry and I'm a Bombshell.
My name is Jaleesa B, also known as the Trophy Life. I'm a media journalist slash artist manager and I'm a Bombshell.
I fell in love with hip hop when I was in high school and I heard one of Lupe Fiasco's songs. So Lupe Fiasco's The Pool album made me love hip hop. I've always liked hip hop, like I always loved music, but that made me really love hip hop. And since then, like it just, the lyricism has gone super low, the artistry has sunk pretty low, but I still listen to everything that came out around this time, Lupe Fiasco, Kanye, Pharrell, just all of that.
The most challenging part about being a media journalist is that men in the field automatically assume that I have help or I don't know what I'm doing or my work is not edited by me. I don't take my own pictures. I do my own stuff, okay? I don't need help. I do what I gotta do on my own. So that's the most challenging part. The best part about being a female industry is sometimes you get free stuff. People gravitate to you more, you're pretty. Like, nobody wants to walk up to no hardback big guy. Like, they like soft and, you know, subtle things to walk and, you know, talk to.
Hi, I'm Brianna T, and I'm a
Bombshell.
Hi, everyone. My name is Pepper B, and I am a Bombshell.
So the way that I balance focusing on college and like staying 100% into my work is by doing my work with something that I love to do, and college was something that I knew I had to do because my mother was playing those games with me being there and not getting my work done. So I just made sure that anytime I did any work that I loved it and I was really passionate about it, and I just used, since there's like 24 hours in a day, half of my time being up was schoolwork, and then the other half of the time was work.
Being in the industry for 10 years, one advice I can give about being patient is actually being patient. So we get frustrated because we do not meet the deadlines that we set for ourselves, but look at it as a way of the universe telling you that it may not be your time. So what you can do in the meantime to prepare yourself is to work diligently at what you need to do in order to get your goal done and be prepared when it is your time.
Hi, it's your girl Style God and I'm a Bombshell.
It's DJ Miss Milan and I'm a Bombshell.
The reason I moved to New York for $300 was just because I had a dream and I was willing and able with the fire to chase it.
What fuels me is pretty much my determination. The fact that I can't stop, won't stop, I'm not gonna stop. That's what fuels me, straight to the point.
I stay true to myself in a world that's so overexposed by just being me and doing me, you know what I'm saying? Like, I don't care about what people think or what anyone has to say. If it makes me happy, then it's lit.
And I say proudly, like, this year I was able to quit my job and I've been working for myself for like the past 6-7 months. Because I always tell everybody, don't do things for the money, do things for the love. The more you do it for the love, the more the money.